Do the clap?
Yeah.
Cinefoz?
Yeah.
And you're just waiting, I'm just ready to go. Are you ready for me?
Yeah.
Cinefoz, action.
Go get him. And do what?
Let him know he's king.
Come on, come outside! I'll dick you, mate! Come outside! Come on, idiot, come outside! Hey! Whoa, 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 brother! Just relax, man. I'm just gonna have a chat to him, alright? Just chill, bro. Fuck this.
Fuck out of here, man!
Mr. David Mitchell, the pronunciation is right?
No.
No?
It's Mitchell.
Mitchell, okay. So first of all, congratulations for your award at the Festival de Beaune.
Thank you. That's very exciting.
We received the news a couple of hours ago. So to begin, could you tell us about the origin of the project of Animal Kingdom?
I basically started when I moved to Melbourne from Sydney when I was 18, and I knew nothing about Melbourne really, and I just started reading a lot about Melbourne's criminal history, and was particularly fascinated with a period in the kind of the 1980s and early 90s that was, you know, that saw the last days of serious professional armed robbery and the last days of a particularly dangerous section of the armed robbery squad in the Melbourne police. And the conflict that existed between these two groups that culminated in 1988 in one event which kind of sits at the middle of Animal Kingdom, which was the brutal and random revenge killing of two young cops by a particular gang of armed robbers. And I found that event so disturbing and so chilling that I immediately started imagining a building my own world of characters and a big Melbourne crime story around that, an event of that nature. And so I just started writing it when I finished film school.
Hey, buddy! Hey! The light's green, you idiot. You got a staring problem, mate. What the fuck are you looking at?
For me, it started with crime, but it became, the more I wrote, the more fascinated I became with the family dynamics of the story, you know. And I think in theory that's kind of true of any kind of rich movie, is that whatever its setting is, whatever its you know, whatever its business is, at the end of the day what makes it feel rich is the depth of its human connections, you know, its observation of human behavior. And so really the movie is full of just family, you know, it's full of my observations of family generally, and I've just put it in a dangerous criminal world. You know, when I started writing that, there was something so kind of visceral and powerful about that particular era of Melbourne crime. I mean, and I talk about the 80s. I didn't want to set the film in the 80s because I didn't want to make a period movie, but But it was that period that fascinated me, and it was its brutality that fascinated me. I knew I wanted to make a very serious crime film, and when I worked that out, I realized that there was no room for gratuitous violence, you know. There was no room for huge gun battles or anything, because those gun battles don't actually exist in the real world, you know. I mean, they exist in the criminal world. They exist only in criminal cultures that are like war zones, you know, like Mexico, for instance. But in most of the Western world, the guns that these criminals carry don't get used very often, and when they do, it's usually very quick, very sudden, and then it's over.
What was the reception in Australia around the film?
It was good, you know, and I was nervous about the reception the film would have at home, because Australian audiences notoriously hate Australian films for some reason. Oh, I mean, for, you know, reasons that I sometimes understand. And I've seen many really good Australian films just disappear because of that stigma, you know. But fortunately for us, we premiered the film at Sundance in 2010 and got, you know, we got amazing reviews, and we could, a buzz built around the film, and then we won the World Cinema Grand Jury Prize, and we were able to take all of that stuff back home and build the campaign for the film around that, and fortunately it continued. You know, the reviews in Australia were amazing too, and people went to see the movie, which was a relief for me, because I had braced myself for the possibility that no one would go.
Everything reaches an understanding. Things survive because they're strong. You may think that you're one of the strong creatures, but you're not. You're one of the weak ones. But you've survived because you've been protected by the strong. But they're not strong anymore.
Australians definitely have an appetite for noir, for crime stories. It's just that they have an aversion to Australian cinema for some reason. They don't think we do it well, and so, you know, when a good one comes along, when one that has been very well reviewed comes along, Australian audiences are often suspicious of good reviews, and stay away, you know. Fortunately for me, that we managed to break through, and the whole snowball rolled, you know, all the way to the Oscars, you know, and Jackie Weaver's nomination.
Okay, so what would be your next project after Animal Kingdom?
I'm trying to work that out now. You know, this afternoon I get on a plane, go back to LA, and keep talking to people about things, you know. I feel like I've been doing a lot of talking for 12 months, not just about Animal Kingdom, but about what the hell the next thing is. And I think I'm getting close to nailing something down. But you know, there's all sorts of different movies I want to make, and all sorts of different places I want to make them. And I've just been trying to work out, you know, in what order to do things.
So to be continued.
Yeah, stay tuned.
You've done some bad things, sweetie.